Today, in this 2011 Chevrolet Traverse, we're going to show you the Curt T connector vehicle wiring harness with a 4-pole flat trailer connector. Part number C56027. Okay, this is what the parts you get with the kit. First off, we got the T connectors here. This is the yellow that goes over to the driver's side behind the taillight. The other half with the green wire that goes over behind the passenger side taillight. We also have a white wire for ground, which goes to the sheet metal for its ground. This is our 4-pole end right here. Also comes with a cover for it when it's not being used. And also some zip ties and a ground screw as well. Okay, let's go ahead and install a wire harness. It'll be relatively simple. First off, we need to go ahead and open the back hatch. Then we can go ahead and start to work on removing the taillights. Okay, the hardware to remove the taillights is going to be behind these two little covers here. So it pops loose with a little flat blade screwdriver. We'll go ahead and remove the screws inside. We'll use a 7mm socket to remove the screws. You can grip it from the top here and you can pull it back and it pops loose. Okay, disconnect the electrical. We'll go ahead and push down this little tab right here and pull it apart. All right, our passenger side is done. Let's do the same thing over on the driver's side. Okay, let's go ahead and start working with our wire harness. We're going to drop the 4-pole end down the driver's side first. Try to work it all the way out towards the bottom. Okay, now we want to do the same thing with the T connector here at the green wire. We're going to run that down out the bottom as well. It kind of helps run through the opening that goes towards the front of the vehicle. Let's go ahead and pull it down. We're going to take a 4-pole wire harness right to the center of the hitch. We'll just leave it there for now. Then we'll continue on with our green wire T connector and route that to the other side back up to the taillight on the passenger side. Now pull a wire up. We're going to use a pull wire to help us do that. I'm just using an old piece of airline tubing. This also could be any piece of wire that holds its shape and you can guide it down towards the bottom. Go ahead and take our T connector, we'll go ahead and attach it to our pull wire and bring it back up to the top. All right, after bringing it to the top, we'll go ahead and make our connections to the factory wire harness on our vehicle. We'll push it together until it makes a click. And we'll take a moment to take our white wire with the ring terminal and ground it to the sheet metal right here. This is our self-tapping screw. We'll use a 1/4-inch nut driver on it. I'm going to go ahead and attach it to sheet metal. Go ahead and start it by itself first, then add a wire. All right, at this point, we can go ahead and reinstall our taillight on the passenger side. Now we'll go back over to our driver's side and make our connection there as well. Okay. All right, now at this point, we can go ahead and start securing our wires. To make things a little bit easier, we're going to take off the bumper cover here. This little panel that hides the hitch. Okay. For starters, I'm going to take a length of wire, maybe about this much right here. I'm going to go ahead and zip tie it to the hitch. I'm using an extra long zip tie that doesn't come with the kit. It's always a good idea to get some extra zip ties for an odd situation like this. Okay, let's go ahead and take some of the small zip ties that came with the kit and we'll bundle up our excess wire. And we'll use some more long zip ties and we'll secure it to the hitch. Okay. All right, one side's done. Let's go ahead and do our other side. Okay, now when we zip tie our wires, we also want to make sure that our wire that's close to exhaust is far enough away. All right, we'll go ahead and cut off our tails to our zip ties. All right, one of our last steps is go ahead and put the cap on our 4-pole. Slide it over it in place. Then we can use a cap to help hold it to the hitch. it's always a good idea to go ahead and try out your four pole wire harness before you plug it into a trailer to verify that it's working. First, we'll go ahead and check the brown wire for a running light circuit, and then yellow for a left turn signal, green for a right turn signal, and then a brake signal will be a constant signal on the green and yellow wires. All right, looks like everything works. All right, with that, that'll finish it for the Curt T-Connector vehicle wiring harness with a four-pole flat trailer connector, part number C56027 on our 2011 Chevrolet Traverse.